you were to get rid of everything in a certain part of space, any part of space, all the planets, stars, atoms, particles, even light and radiation, that space would still have weight. It would weigh something. It turns out that nothing is not nothing. It is something. What do I mean? And how is that possible? I'll answer that in the next 5 minutes. It turns out that when we think of nothing, it's not nothing, it is something. Space is bubbling with virtual particles that pop in and out of existence. These particles do this in a time scale so short that the laws of physics forgives the creation of these ghost particles that seem to come out of nothing. The laws of quantum mechanics allow this. This is empty space within a proton, and they represent 90% of the mass of the proton. And since most of our physical world is made up of protons and neutrons, this so-called empty space inside is what gives it mass. Here's the analogy. A zero represents nothing, right? But a zero can also be expressed as 1 plus a negative 1, 1,000 plus a negative 1,000, 1,000,000 plus a negative 1,000,000. So this equation, 1,000,000 plus a negative 1,000,000 equals zero, it's the key to understanding how our universe began. The total energy of the universe is zero, or nothing. However, at the beginning of the universe, the zero spontaneously divided into 1 gazillion megawatts of energy and negative 1 gazillion megawatts of energy. The total energy of the universe was still zero, but it was divided into these two huge numbers. The positive energy today is represented by all the matter that you can see in the universe, stars, planets, particles, and radiation. And because energy is equivalent to mass, using Einstein's famous equation, E equals mc squared, where E is energy, m is mass, and c is the speed of light. So the positive energy of the universe is represented by all the mass that you can see. And what about the negative part? What about the negative energy? The negative energy is in the form of gravity. The universe is flat. This means that it is in perfect balance. The total energy of the universe is zero. The negative energy of gravity perfectly cancels out the positive energy of matter. And like my favorite character in the movie The Matrix says,
a harmony of mathematical precision.
The universe has a total energy of precisely zero, but it has manifested itself into something rather than nothing.